Hello dear students of class 8, today I am here with a new video of your English course book. The name of the poem is The Inchcape Rock. Okay, Inchcape Rock is a rock in an ocean which is in Scotland. Actually, this poem is actually a ballad. In this, any story is mentioned, and the story is about, as the name implies, Inchcape Rock. Once in the Scotland, in the ocean, there was a rock. The name of the rock was Inchcape Rock. Okay, and it was so dangerous that if any boat was striking with it, the boat was wrecked. It was destroyed. Okay, and it is a story of 14th century. So at that time, there was a priest. There was a monk called Abbot of Aberbrothok. Okay, what did he do to save the people? He placed a warning bell on Inchcape Rock. As you can see, there was a warning bell on Inchcape Rock. This bell rang with the movement of air. When there was a storm, with the movement of air, this was ringing. So when anyone, means if any sailor passed from there, he used to hear the warning bell, and as a result, he was able to see that there was an Inchcape Rock. Okay, so he was warned, and thus it was very easy to escape through it. Okay, so this way Abbot of Aberbrothok placed a bell and saved so many lives. So all blessed and thanked Abbot of Aberbrothok. Okay, but unlike Abbot of Aberbrothok, there are many evil people, and one of them was Sir Ralph the Rover. This is a villain of the story, Ralph the Rover. He was a pirate. Actually, pirate means a sea robber. Okay, he was jealous of Abbot of Aberbrothok because people always blessed him. One day, what did he do? Out of mischief, he cut the warning bell which was hanging here by Abbot of Aberbrothok. So when this bell was cut or removed, let's read what happened next. Okay, side by side we'll get to read. So what is given here, we'll start from first stanza. No stir in the air, no stir in the sea. Stir means movement. Okay, the ship was still as she could be. Her sails from heaven received no motion. Her keel was steady in the ocean. Okay, keel. Keel is this platform only. This is called keel, where this bell is hanging. So what the poet says here? The poet says that the ocean was completely at peace. There was no movement at all. Okay, there was no motion. The ship remained at one point in the sea. Even the keel of the ship was also steady. Means this was also remained at a fixed point. So as everything was completely at peace, so there was no motion at all. The time was really good. Okay, there was no storm. It means there was no storm. Without either sign or sound of their shock, the waves flowed over the Inchcape Rock. So little they rose, so little they fell, they did not move the Inchcape bell. So as I told you, there was a bell hanging over Inchcape Rock, but now as the waves were slow, they were not striking against the bell. See, one thing is clear, the bell was here. Okay, and as there was no ocean, the movement of air was smooth, the movement of waves was also smooth. So when the waves will strike with it, then only the bell will ring. Okay, so as the waves were moving smoothly, the bell was not ringing at all. Okay, so the bell was not ringing at all. It was completely at a fixed point. Okay, there were no striking at all, so the bell did not ring at all. Stanza 3, let's read. The Abbot of Aberbrothok. First of all, abbot means the head of monks, the head of a priest. Okay, Aberbrothok is a name of place. So here people called this priest Abbot of Aberbrothok only. Okay, so the Abbot of Aberbrothok had placed that bell on the Inchcape Rock. Here it is told who placed this bell. Okay, set this bell on it. Okay, on a buoy in the storm it floated and swung. On the buoy in the storm means with the movement. When any floating object is there fixed at the movement at the bottom, that means a buoy. And over the waves its warning rung. Okay, so how it is written here, Abbot of Aberbrothok was a spiritual person. He was a priest. So as he thought for the well-being of people, he hung the bell over the Inchcape Rock, so that the sailors can be aware of the rock. Okay, sailors can know that there is rock from the warning bell, and they can move from somewhere else. Okay. When the rock was hit by the surge, what is surge? Surge is high movement. Okay, high movement in the ocean, that is called surge. Swell. Swell means when wave becomes bigger. That means a swell. The mariners means sailors, heard the warning bell, and when they knew the perilous rock, perilous means which is dangerous, and blessed the abbot of Aberbrothok. Blessed means blessed. So, whenever there were high waves, the rock was hidden by the waves, the bell used to ring, and the sailors heard the bell. They knew there was a rock, so they were safe. Okay, they were safe. The mariners were safe. How they were getting themselves saved? By listening the warning of the bell. And as a result, they blessed abbot of Aberbrothok. Okay, next. One day, what happened? Here the story is going to change. This is the background. This is the basic introduction of the poem. Now the story is going to change. One day what happened? The sun in the heaven was shining gay. Gay means happy. All things were joyful on that day. The sea birds screamed. Screamed means made sounds as they wheeled around. Wheeled means turning around. Okay. And there was joyance in their sound. Joyance means joy only. Okay. One day what happened? When everything was fine, the birds were flying around the sea and screaming. Even the birds were also joyful. Means here, happy atmosphere is described. As everything was well, the birds were also flying here and there. They were seagulls and other birds were touching the sea. Okay. Everything was completely joyful. Everything was completely full of life. Okay. Let's read further what happened. The buoy of the Inchcape Bell was seen. The darker speck on the ocean green. Okay, speck means a small sign, a small spot. Sir Ralph the rover walked his deck and fixed his eye on the darker speck. Deck means ship. So now we get the entry of our villain of the story. The hero of the story is Abbot of Aberbrothok, and now there comes villain of the story. Okay, that is Sir Ralph the rover. So there is the entry of Sir Ralph the rover now, who is a pirate actually. Keep in mind, pirate is sea rover. Okay, from the boat of Sir Ralph the rover, Inchcape Rock could be seen so far. So it seemed as there was a black colored dot in the green sea. This line is given, a darker speck on the green sea. So from the green sea, far away, he could see a small sign, small black colored dot. And Sir Ralph the rover is looking at the rock. What he is doing? He is looking at the rock. He understood, okay, this rock is having a bell over it, and he also knew this bell was actually hung by Abbot of Aberbrothok.